Hi, this is Luke. So I made myself kind of like a little tone generator set up on my Logic system. And we're going to listen to some tones, sine waves, and we're going to combine them in various ways. And you're going to see a little bit about how harmonics work. Now, I'll probably end up using the word overtones and the words harmonic. They're really the same thing, to all intent and purposes, for what we're talking about today. So we're starting off with the 300 hertz tone. Now, that's going to be the loudest of all the tones we're going to hear, and that will make it the fundamental. The fundamental is the loudest of all the tones that a particular instrument or pattern of waveforms might generate. And that's the tone. When we hear that tone loudest, we go, oh, that's the pitch. So if we hear 440 the loudest, we go, oh, that's an A. So we're just using 300 because the math's easier. So we have a 300 hertz tone, and then we have its a doubling of that, which would be 600 hertz. And then we have a doubling of that, which would be 1200 hertz and 2400 hertz. So we have basically octaves here. But this is very typical of the overtone series most instruments, is a series of octaves. And you notice you still hear it as 300, because that's reinforcing that really well. Now, if I bring in this 300 and then do some odd number harmonics where it's not pure doubles, 2 and 4, instead it's 3 and 5, it's going to sound quite different. So here's the fundamental at 300. Now, this is 900 hertz. And that's just not that pleasant. Now, this is 1500 hertz. Still not that pleasant, but when I add in seven times that, which is 2100 hertz. All right, that's really pretty nasty. And even if I have other harmonic components in there, it's really buzzy and out of tune. So we don't really like that sound very much. And our ears don't really like that sound very much. Who's still on? Oh, 600. Okay. So here's my fundamental, 300 hertz. This is a third. So this is a mathematical relationship of 5 to 4. And you're starting to hear a chord. And then this is a 3 to 2 relationship for the fifth. And now you have a nice, good sounding chord. And that all sounds good to our ears. That's all pleasant to our ears. Now, if I keep this chord and I add in some of these odd order harmonics, it's pretty bad. Our ears don't like that. Now, I'm going to record a little of all of these, and then we're going to take a look at the waveforms. Okay, here's 300. Here's 600. You can see it's going twice as much. And then if I add 300 back in there, you get the start of what's called a complex waveform. If I add 1200 in there, turn these other two off, you can see that's even faster. But if I go and add them back in, we're getting a more and more complex waveform. And now this is 2400 in. And you can see the waveform is really complex. But you notice it still has a kind of a musical pleasant shape. And I want to compare that with, here's, I'm going to add in the third and the fifth. And again, we have a complex waveform, but it has a pleasant shape. Now watch what happens when I add in some of these odd harmonics. So this is 300, and this is 300 times 3. And this is 300 times 5 mixed in there. And this is 300 times 7. So that's all those odd harmonics mixed in there. And if you look at that waveform, you will notice that that waveform looks like a square wave. And this is super important to remember, that square wave shape. That is a really important thing to remember. And we'll see in our next video and our next blog article why.